spatial science has evolved with technology, with society, and now every decision that gets made has a spatial element. Every decision someone has, whether it's whether you want to go and find the nearest coffee shop or work out how much sea level is rising, you need to ask the question where and how much.
The survey in Tasmania has been here for 50 years, and there's not many other places in Australia that can say that they've had that legacy and they've had that presence. And I think we've had a really distinct advantage here in that we have such a strong environmental presence, and we as a surveying group have been part of that.
About 10 years ago, I started a research group looking at the use of drones for Earth observation. So using drones as a tool, as a hook in the sky, and essentially collect really high resolution aerial photography and data. So some of the early work we did was quite high risk. We built these drones ourselves and didn't know if it was going to work, didn't know if it was going to be successful. And so it's a really exciting area to work in.
Well, Earth observation is work that I enjoy. It's being able to have an impact on a lot of people. My project runs over all of Africa, so we have data covering every single African country. We're making data available for free that's never been available before. And it feels great to be able to do this sort of common good work.
Spatial science is enormously important. Every time we get in a car or pick up our phone, we're interacting with it. As it's telling us where to go, giving us a location, it's become completely embedded in our world. So sometimes we forget that underneath this incredibly rich set of experiences we're now able to have is all of that work of spatial science.
It's not just being a land surveyor and capturing angles and distances. There's so many different careers in surveying and spatial. It's a really cool space to be in.
One location is never the same. One job is never the same. Every job's different. They can be similar, but there's different challenges to each job. And so as a trail runner, I really like to explore and have adventures.
There's so much unique stuff going on here. You don't just sit in the middle of a massive city all day. You can see the things that we talk about all around us all the time. And, you know, the data that we use to teach students with data that's from around here. So they learn about Tasmania as the island, as well as learning about the type of information that exists and the type of information that we can make to solve problems that people might have.
I don't think I would have had the same opportunities. The university offers the academic freedom to think creatively and try things. And in a research environment, you have that opportunities to try things, to fail, to try again. Something I also really enjoy is working with students to help them through that journey, to design experiments, make mistakes, and improve along the way.
The next 50 years, I think the skill set is only going to be more in demand as we use positioning and location or remote sensing or earth observation in our everyday life.
And as a university which kind of takes place as an organising theme for what we do, in a way, what more foundational discipline could you have? So wherever you look, it's there. And so I think it's something universities should be enormously proud of. And there's something I think quite special too, because if ever there was a discipline that had demonstrated that scale is not a limit in a university, surely this has got to be it.
If we're going to understand climate change and sea level rise, we need to understand the polar ice caps. We need to measure them, we need to monitor them and map them, and that's what we do. If we want to understand how to protect our forests, we need to monitor and measure and map them, and that's what we do. It's one of those amazing applied sciences that has real world outcomes, and you know, that's what makes it exciting to me.